of this town council at Carnegie. Lord, we thank you for one another again, and we ask as always that you'll give us quiet minds and collective minds, and that we will listen to one another, and we will be respectful to one another, Lord, and get through the agenda in an amicable way. Lord, we do not buy away for a robust debate, Lord, that's not what we're about, but we're friends and colleagues, and Lord, just bless our meeting tonight as we come in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you. have not eaten them.
Planning application was already on agenda, had the opportunity to put it on, and I thought people would want to see that one with plenty of time. Anyone else got any interest coming up this evening on the agenda?
And obviously stick the plant in.
Do I need to declare on that one?
It's only if you're representative outside that. Again, as I say, at every meeting, if something else comes up that you think you may have an interest in, please raise your hand. Because very often when you get into discussion, you suddenly realise you have an interest.
Margaret, just you better know the first one because I know the person who owns the shop first.
Right, okay.
I don't wish to get involved in that.
That's good. Is that the good?
Yeah, I know the owner.
Oh, yeah.
Very well. Not for me to say anything.
Good, thank you for that. Moving on then to item 3, minutes of the special town council meeting held on the 11th of July.
I'm happy to propose those. Do you have them as well?
Do we have a second then?
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. And moving on again to item 4, minutes of the town council meeting held on the 25th of July.
Thank you.
Okay, item 6, requests from a member of the public.
These are for noting.
Noted.
Thank you.
Now item 6.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I have a request.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay then, moving on then to the main part of this evening's meeting is the amendment to the standing orders, item document 4.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I trust everyone has a chance to look at this report. We've had extensive discussion on this matter, but the legislation has been passed. Clerk Association are still very angry with this. Legislation and the lack of consultation on it. However, we need to have another film. This standing order is, I feel, appropriate for the town council to add to the standing order. So, I'm happy to any comments regarding this matter.
Thank you.
Ms. Mann,
yes, thank you. I've seen this is extremely sensible. It's been approved by DOF, so. And simply in addition to our standing orders to cover this matter. Mm-hmm. It's in line with Roxbury's standing orders.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Chairman, I have had a chair.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Councillor Winder?
Yes, I totally agree with what Councillor Winder said.
Do we have any comments? Okay then, but those all in favour for in for the current amendment to the standing orders to the town council. Thank you very much. Thank
you. There we go, Mr. Chairman. I think if you looked at these, all afternoon, and I think it just shows how young people are and
you, Phil, after the I think the big step for them, a number of Roxton things and things, a number of things. That was one very good event. A lot of other events over the summer, there's been the opening of charity shops, there have been visits to various people. There's a lot of events coming up. I have a lot more to put on engagements that I'm just confirming at the moment, and we will of course have the privilege of organising round of funding once again this year. I'm waiting on the new Methodist Minister coming into place to finalise arrangements for that this year. So I think the busy programme, if you've had a chance to look at your emails or the newsletter that's come out, I'm very fortunate to see that there's many events within this programme, which I hope you support. I know the church is very excited about us hosting with St. Helens. We also have our in-time council event at St. Helens, which is commemoration day in October, and invitations will be going out to that very shortly. Thank you.
First of all, as Mayor of Roxhill, I would like to thank the Council of the Hall for coming to the Menace Fashion Show this week. And can I say it was much more appropriate that she'd get than rather than me.
What are you saying about my fashion?
She was beaming away there. She was very, very happy. And it's really great that, you know, that on behalf of the Council, that she was supporting. And I've announced that we raised £375 towards the member of the charities, which are cancer research UK and Hawkinson, which brings the cumulative total now to just over £2,500.
Yeah,
that's great. And then the next thing I'd like to say, I think it was after the last council meeting that many of us went to the funeral of that farm and the members of it. It was great to see, you know, those people who were able to support that occasion. And it was one of the most beautiful funeral services I've ever been to. It was so well lit. It was beautiful. And it was a real tribute to her and to Ray Clark, who of course who was a councillor here some years ago. In fact, he was a mayor of Stapleford Town. I was just there as an ordinary member of this council, and I was just delighted with what happened. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sam.
As I was trying to go on, can I just say that the Kensington Town Centre team was running down there.
I also mentioned that on the expression of interest, you know, shall I mention that a member of the Town Centre team is actually my champion and is running the Chairman, I have a
sponsorship from any members of the Town Council
who
would like to sponsor the
Absolutely fantastic.
When is it?
The end of September. Not far away.
Thank you very much. And my thanks really. Quinn to Ray, because I think I've been quite busy with work at the moment. Ray stood in for me for a lot of these events, or so thank you very much personally for me, Ray. So thank you for that. Can I just remind everybody, we have the carnival tomorrow. If some people could help me set up the gazebo at 10:30, that would be great. Much appreciated. And I have all the boards and everything else in the back of the car.
Okay.
Right, shall we move on then to the next? Moving on, item 9, allotments.
Mr. Chairman, you have my report in front of you. These figures are correct up to the end of July because obviously the agenda went out for those deals. The figures are correct up to the end of July. Yes, because they went out, the agenda had to be dispatched before the end of August, so I'm sorry about that. Very quick, just to go through everything, I visited an excellent event at the Auburn site with Diggins, 10 years of Diggins, great fun at that event. I am working with Diggins with regards to the Welsh Library, so for next year we'll have that on board. I've also been working with Trump Friction for going to take over a plot to help young people, especially to go through and to link it into the Trump Friction project, which is fantastic. So I'd like to pretend I could do that. There, all the needs to be going well apart from that, I would like to put a few plots on that side. Bessel Lane, I have no issues with that, we'll be doing some hedge work, internal hedge work on that site later in the year. Ulam Lane is again going ahead not too bad. Nottingham Road, I can't get enough plots on Nottingham Road to give out to people.
Can I just take you back and come yes. in to Ulam Lane because the hedges have now been cut?
Yes, the hedges have now been cut. And I've also been discussing this matter with the Broxford Council, and I will be now going back to something we used to do, we're not allowed to do again, which is for Broxford to become an agent, for us to become, they will become our agents to cut the hedges, which means if they kill any birds' nests, they're probably not on. So I'm happy to do that, yes. And that will be sorted for next year. Yes, Laura Churchill and I have been back and forth on this with our agent managers. Again, Heatfield, I have problems.
Do we have any other comments about allotments for the town grant? Good, thank you very much. Yeah, moving on then, item 10, town centre management team.
Mr Mayor, there hasn't been a meeting since the last council meeting, but there is a meeting next Thursday which Councillor Williams is attending on behalf of the simple reason I'm called the TCA Department. They will be at the carnival tomorrow and they will be bringing them back to the end.
So, Mr Chairman,
the
town centre team will not be at the carnival tomorrow. In fact, the Town Council will be dishing out adult Stapleford bags.
Oh.
Yeah, I think we'll be back closer to the show. The town centre team will not be at the carnival.
Oh, well, I only say that, Mr Mayor, because I don't have an email last night. So, my apologies if something's come through.
My understanding is the town centre team will not be at the carnival, and Matt the town gave me a great big bag of bags for me to hand out.
I wasn't aware of that.
Can I just say, you asked me to invite Town Centre team to give you a presentation to you, and I've been in discussion with Mr Bacham regarding this, and what he's going to do is put a special presentation for Town Councillors. So we're working on that at the moment, and I will let you know when we need for that.
Thank you. Anything else on the Town Centre management team? Okay, so moving on then. Item 11, core strategy, local plan.
Yes, Mr Chairman, as you know, this matter is very important to part. Broxford Council are discussing it on the 17th of September, and the final plan hopefully will be in place at that point in time, and we will move on from then.
If I can answer that, Mr. The core strategy will come to Broxford Council, which is the responsible body. At the full council meeting on the 17th of September, and it's at that meeting that we'll be deciding whether to approve the plan or whether to reject it and start again. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Well, can I ask that we put it on the next agenda, please, so that we can feedback from the decision that's taken at Roxburgh?
I'm just linking into that, Mr. Chairman. I understand the Roxburgh Council are now working on a date for members to as soon as that happens, it will be open to all town councillors.
Okay, thank you. Any other comments on core strategy? Thank you. Moving on then, usual item 12, Stapleford matters.
Thank you, Mr Chairman.
Let's go through them in order. Parking and traffic. Dear to some of our hearts, Orchard Street and Lower Orchard Street, your picks?
Ongoing, I've been presented with petitions to the County Council, I haven't had feedback as yet.
Okay, thank you for that. Edward Street?
Chairman, I haven't heard anything back on this one. Ongoing again, as far as I'm aware, there is a care system there, but it would be a whole time. I don't know whether you want to keep this one on or whether you want to let it go.
council almost spent a huge amount of time and did sort of the work, the decisions made about it. But I think in view of recent developments and so forth, in the tram and all the rest of it, that there are certainly a number of people coming forward requesting permit parking in any of their areas. So I think, you know, it's something that we can perhaps get a bit more detail from the county now that the summer recess is over and be that back in due course.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah, really, I was just going to say, I think we just keep it as a general sort of thing, because Orchard Street, though Orchard Street wasn't in the areas that were originally considered anyway, so that's a totally different area. I don't, from my recall, I don't think Edward Street was. So they are areas that would be added but were not included in the original scheme. Wellington Street, I think, is a problem because it's already been discussed and decided. And we all know about the road junction at Warren Avenue and Derby Road. That's down to the county council, by the way, sorting that until now. But I think if we keep it on as a general thing, that also means if we keep it on a general issue, if other areas that start to get affected, we can bring those in rather than just limit it to those things that are in favour.
I'm aware of other areas that are calling for parking permits. So I think if we do have it as a general matter, we do know that the Warren Avenue Derby Road has been approved. It's just getting round to them actually, they have to give the
it's
probably
it needs to go again for quantity, then come back. But it will happen.
Good.
Councillor
Brindle? Yes, I agree with something needs to get on. It's something that's being worked on from George Elder. There are more things coming in, and I'm sure the councillor, Evans local councillors on the county, will do the very best. And I know that councillor Townsville is trying his very best with councillors to actually get some of these things resolved. So, yes, it should be kept on.
Yeah.
They were brought by members of the town council.
As an aside then, Ray, any updates around Wellington Street?
No, we're still being ignored, of course. I've wrote a letter to the chief executive complaining about the contempt that the officers are treating councillors and the public with. I don't think it's right for the issues on Wellington Street have been on so long now, everybody's just fed up. You know, they just assume the council that's the problem. It's not the councillors, I think it ought to be highlighted, but it's the county council that's the stumbling block in this case. And more than that, I know that's exactly the same. It's a stumbling block. I know the application's gone in, but their budget year, it starts April. Well, I went round with the officer on the 23rd of April, when he should have quite a bit of money in, but still nothing's done. And I hope he's good enough. I hope he's just ignoring our requests and advice. And of course, you could add on to that if you wish the ordinance, because that's one part of the problem.
Thanks for that, Councillor Darby. What's our best course of action?
The difficulty with this discussion on this particular item, of course, is that we're not allowed to move to more general items and continue the discussion. But can I just, in response to Ray, can I just say that anything that requires changes in parking arrangements anywhere in the whole of the county takes a long, long time. When a request is received, is considered. If it is considered appropriate, it then goes after consultation with the general public. But there are the written responses for consultation, and the average time between a request being made But can I also say this, just so I don't come back in, that we actually, you know, we do have this public scheduled company transport group, which happens to meet in this group this morning. And I think that this morning I was really happy, absolutely really pleased with the meeting, because a lot of the things that are actually being working on actually came to fruition, didn't they? So, for example, Wesley and, what's it called? There's been problems with parking there for ages and ages and ages. And it's been huge problem for the electrical contractor who's got a business down there. Huge problem. And the health centre that borders that have been very keen on helping resolve the problem. And it took actually, I don't know how many meetings it was on the agenda, it was something like 18 months or 2 months. But ultimately it's been done now, and it's been the problem resolved. You know, so it does take a long time, but they are moving forward to a process, you know.
If I could just reply to that, I appreciate the answer that you give me there, but if I refer to Warren Avenue, when they put the parking on both sides of the road, I can't recall anybody coming back and taking any advice there. The main advice was it's going to be dangerous, and people say it's going to be dangerous, and it still is. I mean, if you can put the restrictions on quick, why can't they take off just that way?
Actually, in response to that, a change that has been made can't really change without going through a whole process again.
Yes, but we can't change in the first place. That's what I'm going to ask. We can't put it in the motor. And I think I'm probably sure they hold it.
Mr. Chairman, I think this is all part of our major consultation, and there were rubbish consultants brought in. And it is history now.
Thank you for that, and thanks for the update on that. Listen.
Yeah, all I was going to add is partly what Town Clerk has already said. But whilst they'll recognise that there's probably a mistake in what was done at Warren Avenue, once it's been done, it needs another traffic order to undo it. And you cannot just undo it without another traffic order once that's been passed. So I appreciate it's annoying and we've all told them, but they can't just do it without another traffic order. That is the law. So that's why it's taken us on.
Okay, thank you for that. We move on then. I think we will leave the parking issues on as, in general, as parking permit areas. Let's move on to the correspondence then. We have there.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, since the last meeting, I thought you'd be interested in tonight. And I've been down to Stores Limited and the Station to Community Consultation event, which I attended as did a number of councillors. I'm counselling you not to discuss this matter because a plan will be coming to you, I understand, within a 6 week period. We need a chance to discuss it then. But they are looking for feedback, and if anyone would like to send any feedback, please note the feedback form that can email that to you.
I believe they're ritual councillors anyway.
So if anyone wants to send feedback, that would be up there. We'll be sending it as an invitation. Remember, if you do send feedback, when we come to discuss it as a town council, we will have to do that.
Thank you. We'll be delivering this to you.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay then, let's move on then. Next one?
Yes, nothing to kind of care. Just to let you know this temporary road closure. Again, given where it is,
okay then, item 14 then, planning applications. We have three planning applications that have come up.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, as I say, I have put this addendum on. Also, I don't know if you noticed, I had a little box on your agenda that came to you by email. Click here to see application details on the website. I hope this worked for people. I took the actual item straight from our council's website, and you should be able to click it down and see the plans yourself without having to go through the system looking for them. So I hope that works for people. And I plan to do this in the future.
Obviously, first we have to discuss is the Barbie Blooms 98 at Derby Road. I hope everyone's had a quick look at it. Can I ask for comments first of all?
Okay,
I agree. Dave, you've
generally
got something to say?
No, I said. Okay. I know you did the only very well.
Okay,
I've had a
look at this. It makes sense to have a second, for me personally, I think it makes sense to have a second floor there. It's the only one along there that's got a flat roof. And so I've got a look at the plan, but I can't see any problems. Does anyone else have any other comments?
So, you know, another union from the town.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, all those in favour?
No
objections. All those in favour?
No objections.
Okay,
thank you very much.
Moving on then, the change of use on the ground floor of the HSBC. Has everyone had a look at the plans on this? This is done for council before. Do we have any comments?
Do you have our previous comments?
I know they are. Your previous comments were that, well, you welcome new businesses to the town. Your main objections to it were the difficulties of deliveries.
There were other aspects.
Yeah, there was also the standing outside. I have been contacted by the planning department telling me if it's not a planning issue, people stand outside premises and smoke, so they can't take that into consideration.
Parking.
If parking and delivery are issues.
And I suggest they stand as concerns.
Yes, major concerns I have. Councillor Cray and Councillor Pearson.
I was just going to say, the same thing, that is the parking of big trucks on two busy junctions. It would be nice to have a business in Stapleford. You know, we're not going to say we're not doing business, but it's a shame there's nowhere for a great big lorry to pull up safely. That's my only concern.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's all I would reiterate. I looked very, very carefully. I can't see how you can possibly deliver at that location, and that's my objection. That's the main objection. I think that's the thing we should put. It would just block the road, whatever time they deliver. There's no way they could deliver.
Yeah, I agree with you there. Plus, they've also now removed the living space, the flats above it as well.
But regardless, that wasn't the objection, was it?
No, absolutely not. Okay.
In fact,
Mr.
Chairman,
yes,
it's important. You were very capable, as you are talking about,
Do we have any other comments on this?
Just to clarify a position, this is probably a transferred licence from one of the Nandek codes. I don't think this will list the.
Councillor Hexton installed, then I have Councillor Pearson.
Just to make sure that, for example, members of the public are completely aware of this, we are not the planning authority, and all we're going to do today is offering our own comments on those points, and any final decisions will be made by the planning authority, which is not for a council member.
Absolutely.
Yeah, just very quickly, as Margaret said, it's not our job to think about the licenses, but having looked at Aldi's situation, that Aldi have not bought the area that includes the main store, that's totally irrelevant anyway, because that's not part of the bargain.
That's outside this.
So outside this thing, so our objections stand on the delivery.
Yeah, I think, to summarise then, we have major concerns, as previously stated, especially around the gridlocking of the town and the parking and delivery. Okay then, thank you for that.
Can I just check that you're on with those comments, please? Could you show, do you support the previous comments, please? Do you support them?
Okay.
Yeah, thank you very much.
And the last planning application that we're considering tonight?
We can't discuss that one tonight because it's not been sent out. We've noticed that the members of the public have been given 5 days.
Mr. Chairman,
it's not been put on the town council's website, which it has to be. In the new rules that were passed last month, council's cabinet going to committees to see how it works. It says here
Your council must give the public a notice of the meeting at least 5 clear days before it takes place. Now, this is on Roxburgh Council's website last Friday. We didn't come out on, we didn't get the amendment until Monday. That's not 5 clear days. There might have been members of the public that wanted to listen to us. They might have wanted to request to speak to us at the beginning. And if we discuss this tonight, we deny members of the public that chance, and I don't know how.
Mr. Chairman, that I was advised of this application on Monday afternoon. There was an item planning application on the agenda which allowed me to add this as an addendum, which I did so. It was sent out on Monday,
It's 5 clear days. That's not 5 clear days.
And it doesn't include,
the day of the meeting on the day it was sent out.
Planning application was on the agenda, so I can add
But this one wasn't, agenda. So you can't really discuss
planning,
it.
The item is planning application, and I added it.
But it's denying members of the public the chance to come here and listen and request to speak at the beginning. And like I said, it says in the rules here, I mean, I don't like them. It says here, any background papers must be open. It says here, no item can be considered if the item is not available for inspection by the public with 5 clear days notice. They wasn't given 5 clear days notice, so we shouldn't be discussing it.
Mr. Chairman, the item planning application was on the agenda, and I added this as an addendum for the planning application that was available for anyone who wished.
But it has to be on the website,
fact,
it isn't. It isn't even on the website today, so I haven't been
put
it on
the website.
It's
on the website, okay.
But it's not on ours, so we're
not
going to take
anything
about
the meeting. I won't have planning applications on the website because I'm not a planning authority.
No, I meant that we're going to talk about it tonight. People need to be made aware of that so they can decide. They want, like parking, for example, if that's not talking about Washington Drive, I'm told I can't talk about it's on the agenda, as you just said. So this application was not on the original agenda.
The planning application was on the agenda, and so I actually stayed late on Monday night to make sure that that agenda went out and it was on the Town Council on Monday night.
But it has to be on the website as well nowadays, isn't it?
No, it doesn't. We're not required to. Because we're not a planning authority. Towns and parishes don't have to have a website.
Well, I can email you the new books if you want, because it's all on there for everybody to read. And it does make it clear, it's 5 clear days notice, and 5 days isn't from Monday.
I'm sorry, but my understanding is that the item was on the agenda which was planning application.
Yeah, but parking's on there, we can't talk about parking anywhere. Like, yeah, I've raised been told about, sorry, Council Dog's been told about lots of times because he mentioned roads with some specific colonies.
Yes,
this application's not specifically on
there. You're talking about planning application, and I sent the agenda out. Unfortunately, I couldn't send it any earlier, as it didn't come to the Town Council.
Someone wants to work out to work, so I'm trying to get a nice slice of it.
You're very lucky, Council,
to
give you time to sit in the Roxburgh
Council. Well, I'll make sure I'm up to date, so I can make it nice.
Can I have Council Pearson first of all, then Councillor Hefferson?
Well, I'd just like to make a comment that, I mean, this has been discussed before,
yes.
So it is an amended planning application, not a new one. I certainly got the things first thing, and I knew on Friday that it was happening. I don't see as where, I think, probably the rules may apply to a planning authority such as Proctor. We cannot refuse planning applications, so I don't think that applies to us. Because anybody, even if they don't come to this council and don't drop the council, they can put it on the website. So whilst I agree that it was late, the alternative that we would have, rather than being able to discuss it tonight, would be have to put it back an awful long time or have a special meeting that probably half the people wouldn't turn up to. And I would suspect that if we call this a special meeting, the general public wouldn't turn up to it either, just for this application. If it was for something like 35 houses or something like that, I could understand the thing. So I don't see that there is a problem. We have done the best we can to inform the public if it's on the net. So if the public have got general things, they could actually, as Richard said, he keeps up to date on Proctor's website, as I do. But if the general public aren't really that interested, they could actually say there's a planning application, they could contact themselves saying, I'd like to talk about it, you say, well, it's on the agenda because you've got it on. So I don't see that that bars any member of the public. They could have contacted yourself. Has anybody contacted you? No.
Chairman, I should
In which case, I don't see there is a problem.
have to install new batteries. Well, actually, I don't think there's any need for to speak now because the council really personally said exactly what I want to say. And as far as this thing is concerned, we either give ourselves the opportunity to comment, bearing in mind that we are not making the decision, all we're doing is making a comment, or we deny ourselves that opportunity. We want to follow Richard's law and deny ourselves that opportunity.
It's not me saying that, it's the rules, I don't mind.
I'm just trying to follow
them. We have very interesting
respect. You know, if you want to follow Richard's line, whether it's the right line or the wrong line or whatever, and deny ourselves the opportunity to speak on this matter, then that's just leave the box up. If we do want to take this opportunity, which has arisen because the town clerk managed to get it over to us for a reasonable amount of time for consideration, we want to take advantage of that, then let's call it later on.
With that in mind then, can we take any comments then on the revised plans for the corner of the Roach where the Nottingham Buildings Development is going to be? Can we take comments?
Just to say we've always welcomed a redevelopment of that corner. It's the entrance into Stapleford town and really keen to see something improved on that site. There are other corners there, obviously we know, which we've already discussed one, and there are two other corners where there's likely to be future development. So we want to support a development in the location, as you can. That Mr. President, it is a revised and we are here as elected representatives, so we are representing how to
secure.
Mr. Chair, at this point, you also already agreed to comment on it, agreed to support that the site office will be situated in the open state.
Exactly.
And in fact, that is why we asked you to bring this
absolutely. Absolutely, we did.
Okay, thank you very much.
I've
got Councillor Pearson, now
I've got Councillor Long. Well, the Town Clerk's already said one thing, that we've already approved the fact of having an office there, so, and we've already approved the basic things of this plan anyway, and the Council welcomes the fact that he's going to clear that plan up, he's going to tidy it up. The only thing I'm a little bit concerned about, I found that the plans are extremely vague, and I wish there was a bit more clarity on them, but having said that, I've got no objection, but I want to see that corner tidied up. It needs tidying up. And it will be presented a good thing. And it's also going to provide some accommodation above it. So, I think we can only welcome them doing that.
Yeah.
And we were all in favour in the past. I don't think there was any objections in the past. So, I don't see that we should have any objections now. Anything that tidies up that thing is a process, though. So, got to be far better than having a pub on the corner. I mean,
thanks, Ray. Yeah, I think you just reiterated everything that you set before. Councillor Longdon.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor. I welcome any kind of redevelopment in our town. As many times been there before, I have not been there before. This is a good opportunity to start from the road down, but I actually don't go all the way through the town. After the ban itself, I've seen the drawings. As an ex-engineer, I spent a lot of time reading drawings, that's all they are. And I quite like what's in the office. I know it'll
pop. Okay, thank you for that. Does anyone else have any other comments going on? This has been, we've been talking about this for a long time now, a good couple of years now.
Absolutely.
Okay, do we have any further comments regarding this? Obviously, can I summarise and we fully support this, the amended proposal for Boxer? Sorry. All those in favour? Okay, thank you.
Anyone against these abstentions?
Okay, thank you for that. Moving on then to item 15, we're almost at the end. Items for future agenda.
John McGrath wants me to pass on that. He wanted to discuss a memorial of some kind for Lord Richard Attenborough at a future meeting.
Mr. Chairman, he discusses to have Mark I'm not quite sure what you mean by memorial to the
John McGrath just asked me to put on the agenda.
I've spoken to Councillor McGrath. Until the checks are issued, we won't keep it under our funds, and the check is not yet
I think it's a difficult time in the way to find out just what all councils need. It's a really difficult time. And I know that in my role to work for the council, and particularly in the local council, particularly. I would like to commend the chairman of finance and the Town Clerk for their care and stewardship of our members.
Thank you very much for that.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for that. Do we have any other questions about our profit and loss, our accounts?
Any loss.
Okay. Any other comments? Okay, then the date of the next meeting will be on Friday the 24th at 7 p.m.
Mr. Chair,